everyone, and welcome back to another LEGO Star Wars review. Today I got for you is the First Order Special Forces TIE Fighter. What a mouthful. With that said, let's go ahead and start with the minifigures. We do get to these guys, they're First Order TIE Fighter pilots. I'm just going to show you the one because they're exactly the same, and also have the same head as well. What interests me the most is that this little hose piece is actually made of a soft rubber, which I've never seen that before. Next, the First Order crew, and he's nothing too special really. Different head though. Last but not least, the First Order officer. Now, I don't know about you guys, but to me, he looks like he's been out in the sun too long, or he just has a tan going on. Nonetheless, I still like him. And now we get to the actual set itself. I really had a fun time building this thing. It is a blast to build, and it actually didn't take that long either. Now, in terms of features, though this one isn't really one, this can actually be adjusted, but the only reason it's movable so is you can put it into that position at the end of the day. The front cockpit does open. As you can see, I have one of the pilots inside. And also the back does open as well. So you can put the second pilot, and you can shoot down enemy fighters trying to target from the rear. And the control stick is actually the droid, battle droid body part. And what's interesting is the front and back, they're see-through, but the top isn't, which can be opened. And you also do get the two firing missiles that if you go back here and just press like so, goes flying out. And you do get one extra, by the way. And surprisingly, the only stickers for this set are only just four of them. You get the two red pieces, and on each wing, these little things here. So yeah, not too bad, honestly. And one thing I definitely have to compliment LEGO on is the cockpit window. It looks a lot better than the 2012, I think it was, version, which I happen to have right here to compare. Body is different, pretty much, and the wings are the closest similar build. And this is the only gripe I have with this set. Now, the positive side for this set, the wings are sturdy. They don't flop around or anything like this one, which they kind of jiggle and they make sounds and everything. Again, the 2015 version, nope. Now, this is where that negative comes in, though. The older one utilizes Technic pieces like pins and beam to hold the wings in place. This one is held in by clips, like four on each wing. Now, sure, again, the positive side doesn't jiggle around too much, and it's actually a very solid set. My problem is I'm worried that the clips will break, and the wings will just fly off and hit the floor and just explode, so alas, can't be perfect, but maybe I'll get lucky. Maybe they won't break at all. Now, here is the packaging for it, which is a very big box. Utilizing the features it does, pretty much. Now, final thoughts before I go here. I was hesitant on getting this set at first, but after getting it, I kind of wish I had a second one, believe it or not. So, definitely worth picking up if you have the money. So, yeah, if you get a chance, definitely pick this up. It's so worth every last penny or whatever currency you use. And that's all the time I have for this review, guys. Until next time, Admiral, alert my Star Destroyer to prepare for my arrival.